last time was this. We call that, we have an inner product space. We know that this inner product gives rise to a norm. So it becomes a norm in the space. And the norm gives rise to a meter gap. Therefore, examples.
Gosh.
Fibonacci sequence that I'm going to propose. In other words, take a very particular interval A to B, for example, minus 1 to 1, okay, and take this sequence of functions, fn, maps from minus 1 to 1 into R, and defined by fn of t is equal to 0. When t is in the interval minus 1 to 0, and it's equal to nt. When t is in the interval 0 to 1 over n, okay, and it's equal to 1. Then the interval 1 over n to 1, okay? And we can see that this sequence, this given particular sequence, is a Banach sequence. It's not Banach sequence, but it's called 2 now, but it's not convergent. It doesn't have a limiter. It's a very particular case, so you have to simply compute first, you know, fn minus fn, okay, and you need to show that in 2 norm, you need to show that it goes to 0. Essentially, what you can show is that this can be estimated by, you know, 1 over n. So as n goes to infinity, this norm will get to 0. That's infinity. So the given sequence is indeed a Banach sequence. Okay? Then you know you have to kind of show that you know you can't have any continuous function you know as a limit of this you know this Banach sequence. Okay? That if you will have you know if you kind of forcibly assign a limit you know to this Banach sequence, then you know, you will see the contradictions. Okay? So I would say that read out this proof for yourself from Marcus. Read out yourself. Read yourself. The proof directly from Marcus. It's a readable proof, so you can do it for yourself. The next thing that excellent math teacher, then you can see the analogies between the proofs. ultimate mathematician. You can see the analogies between the analogies. Okay. He has lots and lots of influence on Stefan Banach, has lots of influence on modern academics, especially the aspect of analysis. So you can encounter this guy. Along the space of the Banach space, if it is completed, if it is complete, okay, complete with respect to what? Complete with respect to the, the norm associated by. Induced by the norm. So what's the key difference there? Previously you had an inner product of space, and then you say that okay, the inner product of space, because the inner product is going to induce a metric, and if that space is complete with respect to that metric, which is induced by inner product, you're going to call it a Hilbert space. If you have a bounded space, and this norm kind of with respect to this norm, in this space E is complete, then you're going to call that space as a Banach space. Okay. What would be some of key examples? Key examples are going to be that every finite dimensional Hilbert space is Banach space. How about the converse?
Not necessary.
Not necessary. If something is a Banach space, it's not necessary that it must be a Hilbert. It's another answer. You have a norm on E which is complete, it's not necessarily that you should have an inner product on it as well. Okay, unless you have what you call the Banach number. Okay. Every finite dimensional space is Banach space. Now, what would be the roughly argument to see this? Why every finite dimensional norm is based on the Banach space?
So, sir, finite is to Hilbert only. Can he say?
You have to kind of give an argument. So why this must be true? So if E is an arbitrary finite dimensional space. With any norm, okay. Algebraically we can show that it's nothing but it's just a copy of
AD.
Okay. And we know that the norm on E, which could be any norm on E, is equivalent to the norm on KD. Why? Because any two norms on finite dimensional space are equivalent. If they are equivalent, what does it mean? So, if you have a Cauchy sequence which kind of converges in one norm, it's going to converge in another norm as well. We call the equivalence up. Okay. So, if this guy is complete, so he is also going to be complete. Okay. So, finite dimensional spaces are good. There are not that interesting. Have too much norms on that. Just have one norm. The next example that I would like to do is basically this. Recall what was this calligraphic view of omega?
Set up continuous boundary.
Continuous boundary function or just boundary function?
Boundary.
Linear boundary.
Now, what view of omega?
Sir, boundary function. Boundary.
Okay. So, you can see that, what do you call this? Calligraphic view of omega. why this must be true, why we should have such an effort, from where we can find such an effort. The motivation comes from here. Consider this. We know that convergence roughly in infinity kind of implies point-wise convergence. And in other words, we can say that if Fn is a Cauchy sequence in infinity now, it would be Cauchy sequence as well in point-wise sense in Ri. Okay. Consider this. So consider this. Fn of x minus Fm evaluated by can be estimated by the supremum, where x is a fixed number from omega, can be estimated by obviously the supremum of fm of x minus fm of x, where x is from omega, and this is equal to what? This is nothing but fm minus fm in infinity. Agree? But since we know that this sequence is the Cauchy sequence in mu of omega, so this guy must go to zero. Okay? As n comma m goes to infinity. As n m roughly goes to infinity. And this means that this guy will also go to zero as m goes to infinity. Now, for fixed x, what does this show? So that's a Cauchy sequence in V of omega. This is also a Cauchy sequence somewhere. Where it is that Cauchy sequence? K, because the values of the functions are in K, so that's kind of a Cauchy sequence in K. But we know that K is complete, whether it's R, R, C. So, what's going to happen? So it's like this becomes a Cauchy sequence in K, and since K is complete, so the sequence is going to converge. And if it converges, it converges to some limit for each such x. So we have just okay. So this shows that for each x in omega, fn of x, okay, so fn evaluated at x is a Cauchy sequence. Sequence in K. Okay. As K is complete, so it converges. limit of what?
Cauchy sequence.
The Cauchy sequence.
Okay. Of function.
Of the functions in the uniform line. In other words, this sequence Fn converges to F uniform. It's this limit. Okay, whatever this limit is, I don't know that what that limit is, but this limit exists for sure. In other words, this makes sense actually. F of x makes sense. We know that limit, you know, every sequence in A and the R or C has a unique limit actually. So the map is well defined. Okay. Map is well defined. So the next claim is that this guy F indeed belongs to me of omega, and the sequence that we have Fn, it converges to F in uniform sense. Goes to zero as n goes to infinity. So this is the identity. So what we should do? Something similar that we did in the case of F2. Sums, but we don't have a sum here. What do you call point wise are uniform convergence? Only allowed to use those two things. Okay, so consider epsilon. Consider an epsilon positive. Show that for this epsilon positive, you know, I can estimate this difference in infinity bound by this epsilon. Whenever n goes beyond a particular fixed instance, the capital N. Now for this instance, since Fn is Cauchy, there exists a capital N such that whenever you go beyond this capital N, okay, all the terms of this sequence, okay, are going to fall in the ball of the radius epsilon. Okay, this is what the definition of the Banach sequence is. Now, using this definition, show this Banach sequence converges. Is it making sense? And my claim is that the same end will work actually. In other words, that the same end is going to be the end for the convergence. Obviously, you know, from the last inequality I can write also this end. Pointwise can be estimated by the difference in this one. This is what we have already shown. So, for fixed x in omega, and for n, which is kind of bigger than or equal to capital N, if we take m goes to infinity in the last expression, okay? The last expression is going to give us what? It's going to give us fn of x minus fn of x, okay? And time goes to infinity is going to be equal to what?